Use the SPI signal type to see the master-slave data from two synchronous serial data channels using the SPI protocol decoder. We have already added a SPI signal to our project and captured some data. Let's open the signals editor to see its configuration options. Click on the signal name to open the editor, or use the edit menu item. We will skip the general options and describe each option for this specific type of signal. Some decoders may have additional settings in channel options. The SPI decoder lets you choose to invert the MOSI, MISO or slave select channel data before decoding it. You can also disable the slave select channel if not needed. Let's jump to the beginning of the data so you can see the results of changing some of the additional decode options. Select Show Field Idles to see the idle time between fields as a hashed field instead of extending the current field to the next one. Show Partial Field specifies whether to show partial fields or not. Partial fields are fields that were terminated by timeout or slave select before they gathered the full bit count. Show Frame Idles specifies whether idle time between frames should be shown as a single center line, or if the current frame should just extend to the start of the next frame. Skip Bits specifies how many bits to ignore at the start of the buffer. This can be useful for syncing up when the capture starts midfield and you have no way to delimit framing. The range is from 0 to 24 bits. Use the Field Length option to specify how many bits to use for each field. The length can be from 4 to 24 bits. Frame on SS specifies that we should terminate a frame on the slave select's disable edges, and start a new frame on the slave select's active edges. Frame length specifies the number of fields to include in a frame, if fixed length. Set to 0 to disable. The field idle timeout option specifies how long to wait before starting a new field if no bits are seen. Set to 0 to disable. Frame idle timeout. A new frame is started if no new bits are seen for more than the specified time. Set to 0 to disable. This can be useful if there are no sync lines or field counts, but you can see a consistent pause before each frame starts. Clock MOSI IL specifies which clock edge to use to strobe in MOSI data. Clock MISO ON specifies which clock edge to use to strobe in MISO data. SS active level specifies the active level for the SS slave select signal. For more flexibility, you could optionally define two synchronous signals, one for MISO and one for MOSI. Both signals can be configured to use the same clock channel. This concludes our basic demo of configuring the SPI decoder.